Hi, my name is Steve Copes. I'm the concertmaster of the St. Paul Chamber Orchestra and also a founding member of Accordo, which is a string ensemble based in the Twin Cities. We're now in our 12th season of presenting concerts in the Twin Cities and with members of both the St. Paul Chamber Orchestra and the Minnesota Orchestra. And we are so happy that Matinee Music Hall is presenting our concert today. And I'd just like to introduce the members of Accordo that are playing in this concert and what the program is. So this is a chamber music concert based on the around the works of Mozart and Haydn. At the end of the program, we have one of the great viola quintets by Mozart. That was written just a year before his death, the quintet K593, written in 1790. And this is for two violins, two violas, and cello. And concertmaster of the Minnesota Orchestra, Aaron Keefe, will be playing the first violin, and I'll be playing the other violin. And then we'll have Becca Albers, who's the principal viola of the Minnesota Orchestra, playing first viola, Hyobi Sim, who is an associate principal viola at St. Paul Chamber Orchestra, and Tony Ross, who's the principal cello of the Minnesota Orchestra, playing in the Mozart. And it's a four-movement work, and it is just full of so many charms and delights, and like many of the other viola quintets written at the end of his life, so much invention, humor. And even in the first movement, there's a kind of a nod to Haydn, his kind of mentor for much of his life. And Haydn outlived Mozart. And in fact, the quartet of Haydn that we have in the first half is nicknamed The Rider. It's Opus 74, number 3 in G minor. It's nicknamed The Rider for the last movement, which kind of has a galloping figure, very exciting. Virtuosic movement for the quartet. This was written in 1793, a couple years after Mozart passed, in fact, and is one of his finest quartets, especially the beautiful slow movement in E major, just a chorale of just amazing love and beauty. The other two pieces surrounding that Mozart and the Haydn, we start the program with some violin duos by Béla Bartók, the Hungarian composer, and Luciano Berio, Italian contemporary composer. And we kind of mixed these two composers up and did about nine different duos. The Bartók duos were written as kind of educational studies for young violinists. They have many different kind of techniques, and each has a name. And he, a lot of these tunes were from his own studies of the folk playing in Hungary and Transylvania and in the area around Budapest. So there's a lot of flavor, and we try to mix these up and have a lot of variety. And Berio, similarly, with a nod to Bartók and his duos, he titled the very first duo of this set Béla, for Béla Bartók. And each one is named for a certain friend or colleague. And so that's interesting. You can kind of get a sense of the personality of each of the people he wrote them for. So we did about nine duos of Bartók and Berio. And then starting at the second half is a piece by a young composer, Paul Wianco. He is a cellist, went to my alma mater, Curtis Institute of Music. He's also a member of the Kronos Quartet, and he's kind of has a very eclectic life doing all sorts of things. Woodworking, fly fishing, he arranges music for punk rock bands, and he's a fine composer in his own right. So we're presenting his duo for viola and cello, American Haiku. And this is performed by Tony Ross and Hyobi Sim. And it mixes Appalachian style fiddling as well as some Japanese folk melodies. So we hope you take a curious and open ear to this new wonderful composer, Paul Wianco. And we hope you enjoy this program, and thank you so much for tuning in, and hope to have you hear more Accordo programs in the future. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.